Now we will begin to talk about the government expenditures in the USA as a mixed economy from the period of 1929 to 211. In 1928, the government or the federal government expenditures and the state and local government expenditures together makes $9.8 billion. When we make it as a percentage of GDP, it will be 9.4%. It's increased through years until 1950. It was 20.8%. In 2012. It was 37.3 as a percentage from the GDP, which means it's increased over the years in the USA. These government expenditures was the government consumption plus the government investment plus the government transfer payment. As we see from tables or the previous tables, the conclusion is the importance of the government sector has been growing tremendously as the proportion of government expenditures to GDP is rising across years, as we said before. This proportion of government expenditures to the GDP is low in USA. If we compare this percentage to the other industrialized nations, which is represent more than 40%. When we see the structure of the federal government expenditures by category, for example, to year 2011, these expenses will be in transfer payment. The majority of the government expenses in the transfer payment, which represented 58.7% from the total expenditures. The second item in the importance is the consumption expenditure or purchasing goods and services, factors of production by the government, which represented 27.3%. The third item is the net interest paid, 8%. Of course, USA has a low interest rate because it has a low debits for the external wallet. All the percentages in the last column represented at the total 100%. So we can know the priorities or the importance of each item from this percentage of a total federal expenditures. We can see the same government or the same federal government expenditure, but by the function from this table. In 2008, it will be by function or by sector. For example, the health sector, the percentage of expenditures on the health sector from the total expenditures 24.9 or almost 25%. On the national defense, it's 20.4%. For example, in education, it's 2.5%. In public order and safety, it's 1.7%. In transportation, 1.1%. As the total, we have each item a percentage of 100%, so the total is 100%. As we see, it's represents the importance of each activity for the government sector. We can see the same percentage as a pie chart For example, if we see the state and the local government expenditures, the other part of the government expenditures, the government expenditures is two parts, state and local, and the other part is federal. State and local expenditures, the main item is education. It represents 33.7%. Healthcare sector is 22.1%. Transportation is 5.8%, interest payment is 5.04%, and so on. The second part of the balance sheet is how can we finance these government expenditures. Of course, taxes is the main tool for financing government expenditures, or the principal mean for financing these expenditures. Taxes should be distributed fairly between the citizens in the community. Here in this table we see the government revenues in 2011 as a federal government recipients. As items of taxes, the highest percentage of revenue will be from the personal income taxes, then from the payroll taxes, the third one will be the corporate profit taxes, excise taxes or the indirect taxes represents 3% from the total federal government recipients. Custom duties represents a small percentage, it's just only 1.2%, and the others is 5%. So the personal income taxes, it's the main item for the federal government revenues in USA. This is a pie chart for the previous a table represented the federal revenues in 2011. We saw the personal income taxes 24%, the payroll taxes 36%, and the corporate profits 13%, the smallest percentage for the custom duties, which represents 1%. Aging population. As incomes rise, the total fertility rates, which measured by births per woman, decline while improving access to the health care increase the life expectancy at birth. In the next 50 years, we can expect to see more old people around us living longer. We caring in aging population about the impact of this aging population on the public finance, which represents in two items. The demand for the healthcare system will be increased. The tax rates for the social security pensions are likely to rise. The extent of increasing depends on the rate of improvement of expectancy. This table shows the population aging, the percentage of elderly people who is more than 60 years to the total population in the world, selected regions and countries. For example, in the world in 2009, the percentage of people more than 60 years or aging population is 10.8%. Will increase by 2050 to be 21.9%. In India, it's 7.4%, will be increased by 2050 to 19.6%. In United States, it's in 2009, it's 17.9% and will increase to 27.4%. the smallest percentage in Africa in 2009, which represents 5%, will increase by 2050 to be 11%.